You may have seen this on social media, zombie deer disease. The number of cases is actually up across the country and right here in Utah.
The disease was first discovered back in 2002. Meteorologist Alana Brophy looks at where the disease is and how it's impacting our animals.
It's actually called chronic wasting disease. Notice where it's been found, mainly on the eastern side of the state. The first case was back in 2002 in Uinta County. And while the hype is high on social media, it's a disease wildlife managers have been tracking for years. A wooden banister, a chandelier rack with mounts in several rooms. Avid hunter Travis Welch knows when something is not right with a wild animal.
It did look a little skinny, and it was, we were on the top of a ridge, and it was just making laps on the top of this ridge. And we watched it for a little bit, and it was kind of odd.
Growing up hunting in Colorado and Utah, Welch feeds his family harvested venison, and he's known about chronic wasting disease since it surfaced.
Not something that's weighs on my mind, but you do keep an eye out for it, and you know how to handle the meat.
It's not new though. It's been around for a while. In Utah, we started to test for it in 1998.
There are currently 24 states with infected animals. That's 241 counties nationwide, and seven of them are right here in Utah. The disease is from the prion family and attacks an animal's brain, spinal cord, and tissues.
The prions are the protein, it's a bad protein, we'll say. They're extremely stable, and it can be spread by contact. And so that's either contact of a positive animal with another positive animal or contact with a positive animal with a feed source.
The disease is similar to mad cow. Symptoms include super skinny appearance, excessive drooling, droopy ears, and lack of coordination. DWR tests for the disease year-round, during the hunt, and frequently on roadkill. The disease can spread to elk and moose as well. But to date, there is no strong evidence this disease can occur in people.
None of the locations where we have positives are next to major metropolitan areas. So along the Wasatch Front, those areas, minimal concern in those areas right now. And even where there are positive effects, we haven't seen any impacts to any other species or, you know, your dog's not at risk.
While it is not in humans, you still don't want to eat meat from a diseased animal. DWR will test any meat for free. You also want to make sure you handle any venison with gloves. Don, Emily, back to you.